But I've been touring for a while now. Shows have gone pretty well. There's only one place I won't go back to. That's Guildford. Not going back to Guildford. That's a terrible blues song, isn't it? I'm not going back to Guildford. I don't know what it is in Guildford. I don't think they just don't like laughing. They don't. If you smile at someone in Guildford, they look at you like you've got mental health issues. You go, hello. They go, ooh, what's the matter with you? Basically, they stared at me like they were looking out the windows of a bus replacement service. You've never seen anyone smiling out of a bus replacement service, do you? Going, this is brilliant. Much better than the train. Because you visit so many different villages. They look like my dad looked when he found out what his pension was worth. I mean, to be fair to them, it was the week that Margaret Thatcher died, and they're quite fond of her in those parts. And a couple of the things that I said, a couple of the comments that I made, might not have gone down in the spirit that they were intended. All I said was, well, hey! That was it. That was all I said. That was it. I just went like that. Well, hey! I didn't have a party. Well, you wouldn't call it a party. It was drinks, nibbles, few friends, you know. Police were called once. That's not a party, is it? And I happened to mention a fitting tribute to her was when they cremated her, it'd be great if they ran out of coal. That was all. I think there's a lack of banter in the home, in the domestic environment, you know? Like, sometimes I'll say to my wife something like, how long do you think we could all live if we only ate toffee apples? You know, just putting it out there, you know? And she'll roll her eyes and carry on doing something worthwhile. Was in the pub, you get 20 minutes out of that. It's a bloody good question, Sean. You've got the vitamin, you've got the fibre from the apple, you've got the energy, glucose from the toffee. I wonder if the stick pound up into a paste makes a carb. Mmm. We had a great one the other day. We were talking about what's the filthiest teaspoon you've ever seen? Oh, what a night. We had to have a lock-in. It was brilliant. At what point does a lager top become a shandy? Who would you rather share a sleeping bag with? This we did the other day. Who would you? You've got a choice, you're right. You've got one night in a sleeping bag. You've got Ronnie Wood from the Rolling Stones or Jeremy Vine from BBC Radio 2. Ronnie Wood for one or Jeremy Vine. Any takers on this one? Yeah. Actually, you had a lot better response than the one my wife had. I asked her. She turned her back to me, walked over, looked out of a window, and her shoulders went. And she muttered something about, I suppose we got kids and it's better to... Actually, the right answer, people who said Jeremy Vine, that's the correct answer. You know, a lot of people choose Ronnie. They think Ronnie's a bit of a character, and all the anecdotes, you know, a bit of a character. Of course, what they're forgetting is just how bony Ronnie is. Every part of Ronnie is a sharp, jaggedy, pointy edge. His arse is like a piece of flint. Naked, Ronnie looks like a box of KFC when you're throwing the bones back in. He's held together with bits of chicken skin, Ronnie Wood. And he'll be shaking because he's given up the pills and the booze. Ronnie. Yeah, I've thought about this stuff, yeah. Whereas Jeremy Vine, tedious bastard, dull, boring, pointless man, like a warm column of pissy air. But you get the feeling, when he shuts his eyes, 8 hours, straight through, no bother. People say to me, why are you having a go at Jeremy Vine? I say, because I hate him. Seems a good reason, enough. I do, I don't like Jeremy Vine, I'll tell you why. Because, you know, he does that Radio 2 show, and they have these debates on Radio 2. We're going to have a debate today, and they're not debates. They're just ways to wind the country up, make the country an unhappier, angrier place, don't they? Yeah. What? I think that sounded like 8th century Norse. It's Jeremy Vine, I've just realised. It's Jeremy Vine. He's dressed up as a sort of drunken old mad cockney. sneak in. I've heard about this routine. I'll have a couple of super tenants. I won't say anything he can pick up on, because, you know... And then he'll just disappear into the fog like Jack the Ripper. Oh. you have those debates on the show, and they just make the country an unhappier place. It just winds people up. It attracts nutters to phone in. Like, they'll have a debate. They say, today we're talking about sex education. Some people say it happens too soon. Other people say it doesn't happen soon enough. Are they right? Should we have sex education in nurseries, playgroups? Should teddy bears have genitals? And there'll be someone at home going, what? Teddy bears with cocks? No! They're going to put cocks on the teddy bears! And they phone in. And they pick weird subjects to have debate about. Like, they'll pick something like, you know, there was this burglar who'd objected in court to being called a coward. The prosecution called him a coward. He said, I'm not a coward. So they started discussing it, saying, well, is he right? Are burglars brave? Should we admire them? Are they just entrepreneurs? There's people going... And sometimes they do this trick where they leave a detail out to make a little bomb go off in your head. Something like, who's to blame for... We're talking about the obesity crisis. Who's to blame? Is it the government? Is it the NHS? Is it the food industry? And they know loads of people at home going, well, he hasn't mentioned the fat people. Yeah. Today we're talking about binge drinking. Why do you do it? Are you sad, lonely, depressed? Do you have low self-esteem? Do you need alcohol to enjoy social situations? And that's how I burnt my ear.